हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू एंटेना थ्योरी लेक्चर सीरीज। टुडे वी विल सी द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ हॉर्न एंटेना, आल्सो द टाइप्स ऑफ हॉर्न एंटेना एंड सम डिजाइन कंसिडरेशंस टू डिजाइनिंग द हॉर्न एंटेना। अर्लियर आई हैव मेड वन वीडियो रिगार्डिंग विद द बेसिक्स ऑफ हॉर्न एंटेना। ओके, देर आर सम एप्लीकेशंस, एडवांटेजेस, डिसएडवांटेजेस, frequency ranges for the horn antenna. So I will quickly review the earlier video so that the today's session will be cleared easily. So what is basics of horn antenna? So horn antenna is nothing but the microwave antenna. Okay, it operates in microwave frequencies. Basically it consists flaring of metal waveguide. Okay, so at the opening of waveguide we provide flaring. Waveguide is the device which used to transmit or receive radio waves or electromagnetic waves from transmitter to receiver or from receiver to transmitter. So at the opening of waveguide we provide flaring, that is nothing but the various shapes like rectangular shape, pyramidal shape, conical shape, circular shape, sectoral shape. So various types of shapes and size of flaring can be provided at the opening of waveguide. So this is nothing but the horn antenna. This is basic construction for horn antenna. There are some advantages regarding with the horn antenna or the objective behind providing this flaring at the opening of waveguide. These are: the radiation efficiency and directivity of the beam can be improved. Okay, the directivity is improved with the help of the flaring or with the help of horn like structure. So operating frequency of the horn antenna is above 300 megahertz. Okay, it operates at UHF and microwave frequencies. UHF means ultra high frequency and the microwave frequency. So what are the applications of horn antenna, where they use? So they are used as a feed antennas for larger antennas or such as parabolic antennas. Okay, so the horn antenna can be used as a feed antennas for big antennas. Also they are used in astronomical studies and microwave applications. So these are the basic uses of horn antenna. There are some advantages regarding with the horn antenna. Those are: it has moderate directivity, low standing wave ratio, that is SWR, broad bandwidth, simple in construction and adjustment. So what is basic working principle behind the horn antenna? How it works? So it is totally depend upon impedance matching between waveguide and the free space impedance. Okay, so let's consider, first we haven't any provided any flaring at the waveguide. Okay, there is no flaring at the waveguide, at the opening of waveguide, and the waveguide is device which is closed at one end and opens at other end. We are transmitting radio waves from the waveguide in this space, but there is no flaring. So due to what happens, the reflected waves cause some waves gets reflected from the opening. Okay, the waves, instead of traveling in the space, they gets reflected from the opening of waveguide, which ultimately leads standing wave ratio in the waveguide. Okay, it increases the SWR, standing wave ratio. Also there is a so much wastage of energy, loss of signals, and possibly overheating of transmitter. So this is not proper condition from the transmitting of electromagnetic waves in the space. Okay, I will repeat this thing. There should be a impedance matching between waveguide and the free space, so that the all the waves or the radio waves coming from the waveguide will easily transmit in the space. Okay, there should be no loss of signals, or no overheating of transmitter, or no standing wave ratio. Okay, so this is basic objective behind providing this flaring or horn-like structure. Okay, I think you got this point. That is, what is the use of flaring in the case of horn antenna? So we can see in the structure, in the diagram shown, there is a horn antenna I have drawn, and the right side diagram is the cross section of this horn antenna. So I have drawn one waveguide, and at the opening of waveguide we have provided flaring. Okay, this is a pyramidal type of horn, you can say. There are some dimensions. The smaller dimensions are small a, and the height of waveguide is small b, and the larger dimensions are of the horn antenna, or we can say the flaring. The vertical length of the flaring is capital A, and the horizontal length is capital B. So these are some dimensions regarding with the complete horn antenna. So what exactly happens? Consider the impedance of waveguide is about 50 plus or minus 10 ohm. Okay, consider the impedance of the waveguide is 50 plus or minus 10 ohm, that is in between 40 to 60 ohm, and the free space impedance is 377 ohm. Okay, the free space impedance is 377 ohm. So there is a mismatch between impedances between waveguide and the free space. So the radio waves coming from the waveguide, which should be radiated in the space, gets reflect back to the transmitter because of there is no matching between the impedances. So we have to match the impedance between waveguide and the free space impedance. That's why we provide the flaring at the opening of waveguide. Due to that flaring, the wave coming from the waveguide will easily transmit in the space with no obstacle or no resistance. The flaring does this work. The tapering in the flaring are used to match the impedance with the free space impedances. Okay, the basic function behind providing this flaring structure is there should be impedance matching between waveguide and the free space impedance. Like I have told one example, the impedance of waveguide will be maybe 50 plus or minus 10 ohm, and the impedance of the free space is 377 ohm. So to match the impedance or to transmit all the waves in the space, we provide the flaring structure so that there is impedance matching due to tapering in the flaring, and the wave will easily transmit in the space. There are some other advantages behind providing this flaring. It will improve the directivity of horn antenna. Okay, the signal which we are transmitting will have improved directivity. Okay, also there are very less losses of the signal. There is a very low loss of energy due to flaring. We can see that the three axis, the vertical is capital E, which shows the orientation of electric field. Okay, capital E shows the direction of orientation of electric field. Capital H shows that the direction of orientation of magnetic field. Okay, capital H stands for magnetic field, and the horizontal, which shows the direction of propagation of wave. Okay, so capital E is the orientation of electric field, capital H is the orientation of magnetic field, and horizontal direction shows the direction of propagation of wave. In the right side of diagram, it shows the cross section of the horn antenna. Likewise, we can take the cross section of the left side diagram. We will see the diagram which is shown, which I have drawn in the right side. So this is cross sectional view of horn antenna. Here capital L is the flaring length. Okay, capital L, we can see in the diagram, is the flaring length. Theta E is the flaring angle with E plane, that is electric plane. Okay, theta E is a flaring angle with the E plane, which is shown in the diagram. And delta E is E plane flaring difference. We can say path difference. Okay, delta E is E plane flaring difference. Likewise, if we draw the arc that is having length L, but the flaring is has more length, we can see at the top side of this diagram there is a path difference between L and the total length of the flaring. So that path difference is nothing but the delta E, which is nothing but E plane flaring difference. So there are some considerations, some standards formulae. By using Pythagoras theorem, if we apply Pythagoras theorem to the right side of cross section of the diagram, we will get the length is equal to capital A square divided by 8 del sigma E. Okay, capital L is equal to A square upon 8 delta E is the equation of length of flaring using Pythagoras theorem. If you apply Pythagoras theorem to this right side of construction or diagram, we can get capital L is equal to a square is the vertical height of the flaring divided by 8 into delta E. Okay, so there are some standards where delta E should be less than 0.25 lambda. Lambda is the wavelength or free space wavelength, and delta H should be less than 0.4 lambda. Okay, this is a cross section we have taken at the orientation of electric field. Okay, if we take the cross section of this waveguide towards the orientation of magnetic field or towards the capital H, then there will be small change, that is the angle will be flaring angle with the H plane or theta H. Okay, this will be considered only when we will take the cross section of this waveguide towards the H plane or magnetic field, then there will be a small changes, that is theta E will be theta H, and this is flaring angle with the H plane, and delta E will be delta H, and this is the H plane flaring difference. So standards values are given. I have write this some standard values regarding with delta E and delta H. So delta E should be less than 0.25 lambda, and delta H should be less than 0.4 lambda. So we will move forward for the designing of horn antenna. So these are some standard formulas for the designing of horn antenna. HP BW is half power beam width, and FNBW is a first null beam width. So half power beam width for the E plane is 56 degree divided by A lambda, which is measured in degrees. So A lambda is equal to A divided by lambda. The dimensions A and B, which I have shown in this figure. Okay, please consider the dimensions. On that dimensions, the formulas are used. The first formula to designing the horn antenna is the half power beam width for the E plane, which is nothing but the 56 degree divided by A lambda. Then half power beam width for the H plane, which is given by 67 degree divided by B lambda, which is also measured in degrees. The third formula is first null beam width for E plane, which is 115 degree divided by A lambda. And the last formula is FNBW, first null beam width for the H plane, is equal to 170 degree divided by B lambda, which is also measured in degrees. So please concentrate on this dimension, that is capital A and capital B, and the designing formulas for the horn antenna. There is one formula remaining regarding the gain of the horn antenna. So this is basic formula regarding with the gain of the horn antenna, which is given by capital G is equal to 4 pi into AE divided by lambda square into eta, where A is effective cross section of the horn antenna, lambda is the wavelength and eta is the antenna efficiency. So please remember these four formulas regarding with half power beam width on H plane and E plane, functional beam width of E plane and H plane. Those four formulas are measured in degrees, and the gain capital G, which is equal to 4 pi into AE divided by lambda square into eta, where A is effective aperture length or effective cross section of the antenna, and eta is antenna efficiency. So let's move forward. For the types of horn antenna, so I have made one video regarding with the basics of types of horn antenna. In the last video, I have mentioned this point. I will repeat this thing in that video, in this video. So we can see there are various types of horn antennas. The first one, that is A, is nothing but the pyramidal horn. Okay. B and C are the sectoral horns. Okay, B and C are the sectoral horn. B is the E plane horn and C is the H plane horn. Okay, B is the E plane sectoral horn and C is H plane sectoral horn. D is conical horn, okay, and E is exponential horn. So we will discuss about, in this video we will discuss about the sectoral horns, that is number B and C. For the pyramidal horn and the conical horn, I will make separate video on this. So let's move forward for the description of these antennas. So what is pyramidal horn? A horn antenna with the horn in shape of four sided pyramid with the rectangular cross section. Okay, they are common in type, used with the rectangular waveguides and radiate linearly polarized radio waves. Okay, so pyramidal horn has flare ring towards the E side and also towards the H side. Okay, towards the electric field also and towards the magnetic field also. This is the type of pyramidal horn. So what is sectoral horn? A pyramidal horn with only one pair of the sides flared and the other pair is parallel. It produces a fan shaped beam. Okay, the beam shape of the sectoral horn will be fan shaped beam, which is narrow in the plane of flared sides but wide in the plane of narrow sides. This type of often used as a feed horns for wide search radar antennas. Okay, this is main application for the sectoral antenna, which are used in the feed the horns for wide search radar antennas. So what is E plane horn? That is naming B. This is B, which is nothing but the E plane horn. A sectoral horn flare in the direction of electric field, okay, E field in the waveguide. So E plane horn is nothing but the, it has flaring in the direction of electric field. Okay, similarly the H plane horn, a sectoral horn flared in the direction of magnetic field or H field. Okay, so H plane sectoral horn has a flaring in the direction of magnetic field. The last one, that is D, is a conical horn, a horn in shape of cone with circular cross section. They are used with the cylindrical waveguides. Okay, so to feed this type of horn, there is applications of cylindrical waveguides are used, and to feed the pyramidal horn, sectoral horn, mainly rectangular waveguides are used. So we can see the conical horn, naming D, which has cone like structure and the circular cross section. So we'll move forward for the H plane sectoral horn. So this is the basic geometry for the H plane sectoral horn. We can see there are various dimensions, that is small a, अल्फा अल्फा एच दैट इज एंगल कैपिटल ए वर्टिकल लेंथ ऑफ द फ्लेयरिंग एल एच कैपिटल आर आर जीरो एंड आर एच. सो व्हाट आर दोज डायमेंशंस. सो एल एच इज स्लैंट लेंथ ऑफ द हॉर्न. ओके वी कैन सी दिस एल एच इज द स्लैंट लेंथ ऑफ द हॉर्न. आर जीरो इज स्ट्रेट लेंथ ऑफ द हॉर्न. कैपिटल ए इज द एपर्चर हाइट. ओके द एपर्चर हाइट इज नथिंग बट द कैपिटल ए. अल्फा एच इज फ्लेयर एंगल विच इज शोन इन द ज्योमेट्री. अल्फा एच इज द फ्लेयर एंगल. आर एच इज द फ्लेयर लेंथ. And small a is the waveguide height. RH is the flare length and small a is the waveguide height. So depend upon the working principle, the flaring angle, flaring length, the height of the waveguide, there are some standard formulas. For the LH, that is slant length of the horn, alpha H, that is flare angle, and RH is the flare length. So by using these formulas, standard formulas, we can design the H plane sectoral horn. So please remember these formulas, that is slant length is equal to whole square is equal to R0 square, which is nothing but straight length of the horn, plus A square upon 2 whole square. Alpha H is the flare angle, that is arctan of A upon 2R0, and RH, which is nothing but the flare length, has a formula in bracket capital A minus small a and in square root LH upon A minus 1/4. So please remember these formulas regarding with the design consideration of H plane sectoral horn, and this is basic geometry of the H plane sectoral horn. Similarly, we can learn the E-plane sectoral horn. So before moving to the E-plane sectoral horn, there are some other important formulas. I will quickly review on that regarding with the H-plane sectoral horn. So to calculate DH, nothing but the directivity of the H-plane sectoral horn, we have to calculate GH, that is gain of the sectoral horn, H-plane sectoral horn. So these are the standard formulas. First of all, the step first is the calculation of x, which is given by standard formula. The step two is the calculation of gh, which is nothing but the gain of h plane sectoral horn. The first standard formula are given, and the step three is the calculation of dh, is the directivity of h plane sectoral horn. So please remember these three formulas also. So we will quickly see the E-plane sectoral horn. This is basic geometry. So the orientation of this horn is towards the electric field, and the orientation of the H-plane sectoral horn is towards the magnetic field. This is the basic difference between the two. That is, H-plane sectoral horn has the orientation towards the magnetic field, and E-plane sectoral horn has a direction towards the electric field. So the optimal relation between flare height, that is small b, and the horn apex length, that is R0, that produces the maximum possible directivity, which is given by capital B is equal to 2 lambda into R0. So this is basic formula for the directivity of E-plane sectoral horn. Okay, you can consider some standard formulas as comparing with the H-plane sectoral horn for the E-plane sectoral horn. So this is all regarding with the horn antenna, its basic construction, impedance matching concept. Okay, then there are some types of horn antenna, and between those types we have learned the H plane sectoral horn and the E plane sectoral horn, its design consideration and the geometry of figures. So we will see the conical horn and the pyramidal horn in the next video. So that's all for this video. Thank you.